So, welcome back to Tech and Gaming Reviews. Now, we're a little bit late on this video than what we initially were planning on producing this video. So, but we officially have it, and like we mentioned, the TV was going to be a surprise. And now with, you can pretty much guess because of the title of the video, but here it is. This is the Sony X90K full array LED TV, and we got the 65-inch version, as you can tell from the box, and we have a lot to discuss when it comes to this TV, especially mostly positives and good things about this TV. So, if you're new to this channel, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and be sure to subscribe if you are new to this channel, and also be sure to leave us your thoughts down in the comment section down below if you are planning on buying this TV, if this helped you out on deciding if you're going to buy it or not, or if you have like last year's model, the X90J, or the model before, the X900H, or whatever the case is. So just leave us your thoughts down in the comment section down below. Subscribe if you're new. Be sure to hit that like button, and let's get this video on the road, shall we? Alright, so the Sony X90K, it's been a TV that has been on our minds for pretty much ever since it came out back in May and was released in Best Buy stores. And this TV has just been literally on our minds like off and on over the last few months. And because of the fact that we have the X900H, which is the TV that's right there standing up, and, of course, the X90J, this TV has just been on our mind. And like I mentioned, Sony, to me, is the best brand out there when it comes to making the best picture quality possible and just having the best in colors and the best processor, which a lot of TV fans and TV enthusiasts actually say. And so far, Sony is. Sony is superior to all the other brands out there. Well, instead of like LG and Samsung and whatnot, but even after over those two, Sony is king, honestly. I have loved Sony TVs, and this is our fourth TV that we've ever owned. And honestly, what I have to honestly say about this TV is the Sony X90K is probably our best Sony TV that we've ever bought and we've ever tested. We've had, like I said, the Sony X900H behind us. We've had the Sony X90J, which is in our living room. And then we did have the Sony X800H, which is a more lower budget-friendly TV that's only a native 60Hz panel. And even though it was only a 60Hz, it was still pretty good on the picture quality. But man, the X90K, truth speaking, is straight up the best Sony TV that we have ever bought and we've ever tried. So these are all the good things about it. Now, I played around with the TV yesterday after we got it, and this is what kind of brought us to do our video later than usual than what we originally had planned. But we messed around with the TV, and so far I do have to say it's definitely a step up from last year's X90J. And what I mean by that is the colors are so vivid and vibrant, and the higher peak brightness is also an improvement. You get almost roughly around 100 to 200 nits more peak brightness than you did on the X90J, even though the X90J still get bright enough. But the X90K gets even brighter. And the HDR is just somewhat a downgrade from the X900H and X90J, but the HDR is almost basically identical. So the HDR, it still gets pretty bright and still brings in bright highlights, and that is one flaw that I've noticed from the review on ratings.com from this TV that it didn't manage to succeed over the last two models, but it is not too far off. So we tried it out, and we seen HDR, and HDR looks pretty much basically the same in our eyes like the last two Sony models. So personally, the HDR experience is still going to give you bright highlights, and it's still going to make the picture look more vivid, and the HDR is still pretty good on this TV. But other than that, the XR processor that is Sony's new processor that's been put into the last year model TVs, and then this one specifically, it's also a night and day change of, it's a night and day difference, because the X1 processor was good that the 900H has, and then they went with the XR with the Sony X90J. But here is the two trade situations between the 900H and the 90J. The X900H did have a wide color gamut, so the colors did pop and looked incredible on there, but the local dimming was a slightly bit lower than the X90J. The HDR was also good, and you got a slightly lower input lag. So the X900H, okay, for the trade-off situation, over the X90J had better colors. The 90J, however, did not have a wide color gamut, although the colors were still really, really good, but the 900H managed to still have a wide color gamut, and the X90J didn't. But in the trade-off situation here, Sony's X90J has the new XR processor and does not support a wide color gamut. The HDR is slightly better on the X90J, and local dimming is slightly better on there, and you get slightly better higher peak brightness on the X90J. So there's been some trade-off situations between the Sony X900H and the Sony X90J. This bad boy, the Sony X90K, is basically all of the good things from the 900H and the X90J put together. So you get the new processor, the HDR still looks fantastic and still looks really good, even though it's a little bit lower than the last two models. The color gamut, like the X900H, is vivid and it's freaking incredible. The colors pop, and the local dimming is basically on par with the X900H. It's not as good as the X90J, but the local dimming is still good overall. So you get the everything that you would get from the Sony X900H and X90J, but instead they're put together. You do get the wide color gamut, you do get a higher peak brightness, you do get the new XR processor, and this is what brings us to the point that this is personally our best Sony TV that we've ever tried out. And so far, like, gaming on this TV is so smooth, so good for picture quality, and just the colors, like I mentioned, really, really pop, and honestly, it's good overall TV. And honestly, I did not think that this TV was going to be that good, but man, we have proved ourselves wrong. So if you're somebody that is looking forward to getting the Sony X90K TV, honestly, go get it, because you will not regret it. The TV is that darn good, and the picture quality, especially if you're looking at it for the gaming aspect. And another positive thing I did forget to mention with the TV is that it has no issues playing 4K at 120 frames a second. So this is Sony's first TV that they built from the ground up to fully support and fully max out the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X potential with 4K at 120 frames a second without any issues. And the X90J had some bit of issues from what we've noticed. And then the Sony X900H, when Sony released the first firmware update for it and expanded it a little, it wasn't working properly from what we read, but the reviews have stated that the Sony X90K actually has no issues displaying 4K 120 FPS gaming or just 4K 120 anything. So that's another good plus with this TV. So yeah, if you're looking into getting a new TV that takes full advantage of the PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X, or Xbox Series S, or gaming PC that takes fully advantage of all the features, definitely get this bad boy a try. Especially for the 65-inch behind us that we got for $1,200, you ain't getting a deal that good for the picture quality and for the price and for a big screen, decent size. You're not getting anything for that price. So $1,200 for the best brand with the best processor with basically everything that you would need with a pretty gorgeous picture quality ever and a pretty good big decent size 65-inch screen size all for $1,200, you ain't going to get a deal that good unless you get something that's close to it. Other than that, like, it may not have good local dimming like this TV has to give you the best in black levels and contrast and all that. And the contrast is another thing that I did forget to mention. The contrast on this TV is also an improvement over the X900H especially, but it's about even as the X90J, so the contrast is still going to look good. And yeah, so if you are looking for a TV that takes full advantage of the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X or in PC max settings or just the full potential of them, definitely get this TV. For $1,200 for the 65-inch size, you ain't going to beat that. So, honestly, the Sony X90K, we have proved ourselves wrong. It's definitely worth a TV to long last you for the longevity. So, definitely get the Sony X90K if you was debating on it, rather or not. So, definitely get the Sony X90K, because you will not regret it. And it's that good. So far there is no negatives. Everything has been positive about the TV. And we are very pleased that we got it. This is Tech and Gaming Reviews. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Hit that like button if you enjoy this content. And subscribe if you are new to this channel, and be sure to turn on notifications so you'll be notified with every new video we upload going forward. But also, without any further ado, leave us your thoughts down in the comment section down below if you already have this TV or if you was debating on getting this TV or not, and if this helped out anything of making you decide whether if you're going to get it or not. So yeah, so just rate, comment, subscribe, turn on notifications, and we will catch you guys out on the next video. Peace out.